onwards to the great book theft. So we had we had a bit of a mystery going on last time. Some historian's translation book has been stolen, and we've been talking to people and trying to work out who done it. There's one question I didn't ask that I think I should ask now that I've pretty much solved the case, I feel.
Hello again, Detective.
What's the dirt?
Well, actually, I had a question for you. What was that number in the book that you've got over there?
You skipped to the last page?
Don't spoil the ending for me.
The businessman Vadim gave me that book last night. I haven't finished it yet,
and I don't know anything about those numbers.
They better not be important to the story.
Well, it does appear that they are. I think I have an idea of what's happened here.
What a mess this is.
Yes, indeed. You don't have anything more for me to uncover? But this is new. Who are you?
Hi. I'm not really sure what's going on.
You've walked into the scene of a crime. Oh, actually, no. Heard you packed up pretty quick last night.
Oh, right. There was an emergency, but don't worry, everything's okay now.
Why do you leave so suddenly yesterday?
Oh, right.
Okay. Ever heard of the Teethmore Bluffs? Teethmore Ruins, rather?
Of course. Those halls belong to my ancestors, and my aunt lives on the property. I mean, for now, she's probably going to have to sell it.
I'll need to inspect your trunk.
Are you sure it's necessary?
Absolutely.
Okay, it's just on the ground.
Aha, good news. The real detective has arrived.
Okay. So, I presume that's the detective. Property of Nicol. I can't believe this is the last time I'll ever set foot in these ruins. I know Auntie H would never sell the land for tourism. She doesn't look well lately. I'm worried about her. The least I can do is ensure the land stays in our family. I've been sneaking out small relics to study in secret. But now it's too dangerous. Auntie H never wanted the ruins swarmed with archaeologists, and that's what would happen if the university found what's really in here. She always said our ancestors' spirits lived down here, and in the cool silence, I almost believe it. It really is a sacred place.
Hmm. Can I help?
Yeah. What do you know about a journal?
Okay, you caught me, all right? I know how to get into the ruins, and I've been going in there for years. Is that what you want to know? So yes, it was me.
That's not quite the issue here, but what do you know about the translation book?
Translation book? I don't know what you're talking about.
Right. There's a book related to the ruins which was stolen, and that's what's causing all this mess.
I thought you were looking for a trespasser.
No. Who would benefit from access to the ruins?
Everyone, except my aunt and my parents, who think the ruins need to stay empty for our old spirits. But there aren't any spirits. I've been in there 100 times.
Where are you going now?
I just wanted to bring home one last reminder of the ruins. I was hoping to defend them like my aunt always has.
Did you steal the treasures in your suitcase?
I didn't steal them. They belonged to my ancestors.
Right. Well, you're going to need to wait here.
Are you the impromptu detective? Sorry it took me so long to get here. The innkeeper just filled me in on the situation.
So you're the real detective, then?
It seems like you've been doing good work here. Do you have a prime suspect?
I do indeed. Now, let's go through these. Historian. He's the one who's lost the book. So, unless he's trying to pull some kind of 4D chess maneuver to try and gain access to the ruins somehow using this book, or the theft of this book, then I don't think it's him. The innkeeper, he wants to sell this place, so he doesn't really have a motive for anything regarding the ruins. Although, if the ruins went into the hands of the Blue Rose Industries, then he might stand to gain a bit of business from them. But it doesn't sound like he really wants to be here anymore, so I don't think it's him. Student. Don't think it's the student that's upstairs. Was it? I can't think of. Don't know who that's referring to, actually, come to think of it. Rudmilla. Well, Rudmilla seems to be over the moon that all this is happening, but other than receiving the book from Vadim, I don't think she's really involved. I don't think there's any of that. I don't think it's the musicians, because, I mean, they want to get out of here because they've got a gig to go to. It's not a case of them wanting to steal away with this translation book. Although they could be using the gig as an excuse. But I don't think it's them. Vadim? Well, he definitely has a reason for wanting the access to the ruins. So it would be in his best interest that the historian had his translation book so that the relics could be translated and verified. In the previous session, we found out that someone had been smuggling relics out of the ruins, and Vadim has access to them. Belinda doesn't seem to really want to be here, just this is all a big inconvenience. Helena doesn't want the university or the Blue Rose Industries involved with the ruins. She has a very good reason for the translation book going missing. We heard that a woman was out at night, scrambling around, making a bit of a racket. And we also found muddy boots in Helena's room. We also found that deed to the ruins out there in the water, presumably trying to get rid of evidence, or getting rid of the deed so it can't be sold. So, I think it's Helena.
Really? That's very interesting. Let me have a look around and see if I can confirm your suspicions. Looks like you're well on your way to becoming a full-fledged detective. Certainly nice to have someone else carry out the interrogations. Sad story this is. Looks like Helena was hoping to sell off the land to the tourist industry.
Huh.
Worth quite a lot of money. Says she was trying to take a final look inside the ruins. That's why she needed the book. Must have been having second thoughts about selling the land. Unfortunately for her, we've now got solid evidence that the ruins are filled with ancient relics. No chance of selling the property now. Ownership will most likely default to university. Well, I'd be remiss if I didn't reward you for your work. Please, accept these glowstones I'm authorized to award good Samaritans like yourself. And I believe my work here is just about done.
You suddenly had an easy job here. Well.
So, you actually weren't the detective after all?
Oh, I might as well have been.
I just had to see if there was anything in the ruins. All my life, I've believed there's nothing but spirits in there. I've started to see that no one else believes that. I can't afford for the land to go to science. Science doesn't pay. But my heart couldn't afford for the ruins to be opened as a tourist location. I just thought the translation book might hold some answers for me. Might help me solve this puzzle. Vadim made an offer on the land. He suggested running his own excavation for sacred objects. But really, I knew he would do I took the book and planned to sneak inside the ruins. Just take a peek. I wouldn't have destroyed anything, and if I found something, I would have reported it to the university right away. Now, the ruins will be opened to the university. We'll just have to see what happens.
Well, I mean, my reasoning was not quite solid, but it worked well enough to get a correct verdict, or correct decision. But yes, hopefully the university deals with the ruins in a fair way. Right.
Thanks for working on this case, Detective. We were worried we'd be trapped here forever.
Oh, good luck with the gig.
Well, I thought Helena was acting strange. Guess you can always count on me, Detective. Who knows? Maybe they will find some cures in the ruins. That would really be something.
Supposedly the place is known for curing things.
I didn't expect things to happen so quickly. I guess the ruins aren't ours anymore. I'm glad the university will be studying them. I've always wondered about everything I saw in there.
Maybe you could help them.
I wish she could see inside. She must have been really desperate to end up taking that book.
And you.
Oh well, I'm happy to hear there's something of interest in those ruins. Well, I guess Vadim won't want to buy my inn anymore. But maybe I'll get more interest now anyway. Who knows? I just might convert one of these rooms into a ruins museum.
Yeah. A budding entrepreneur. I like the man's business sense.
I can't say I'm pleased the case was cracked. I was quite enjoying the excitement. Back to dreary days in bed, I suppose.
I had a feeling you weren't going to be quite so happy with the outcome. Ready.
It's too bad the ruins are going to be swept up by the university. Wasted opportunity. The entire island would have profited from the tourism. All in the name of science, I suppose.
Well, I mean, there's still an opportunity for tourism here. Just not quite as you envisioned it. And judging by those contracts I saw, it's probably for the best. Right, so there's no more things to find around here. Nothing in the detective's room. Just having a quick last sweep for candles. You never know where those tricksy things may be. Nothing else up here. Well, guess it's time to speak with I better go check in here. I didn't speak with you, and I haven't spoken with the historian yet.
Finally! We can leave! Maybe we'll get to play in Narva after all.
Well, good luck. And there's nothing else in here. Okay. So let's go speak with the historian.
Well, after we recover the translation book from Helena, maybe I can get my position at the university back as well. The ruins have always been important to her. I only hope I can preserve them for future generations. And imagine what we can learn about the past. Eventually, I hope it will be better this way. If we uncover even one artifact, the ruins will be protected forever. No tourists, no names carved in the walls by hooligans, no trash tossed around. Just a bastion of history. On an unrelated note, I saw the, shall we call it the watercraft you arrived here in. I've drawn up some instructions for you on how to build a reed boat. They're commonly used around here. No need for whatever that thing is.
Well, thank you very much.
You'll also find reed boats quite capable of coastal travel. I can't imagine your contraption there is.
Not really, no.
You'll need heavy reeds. They're wider and flatter than the usual sort. Best wishes, and, sorry for accusing you of taking my translation book. I'm sure
worried.
You understand.
It's all right. So, can I build the reed boat now? Yes, I can. Excellent. Hello, Mr. Aeroplane. Don't know if you can hear that in the background, but it sounds like a plane is flying overhead. Yeah, can't, can't go out onto that pier for whatever reason. Oh well. Guess I'll have to do it the conventional way then. Oh, this is much faster. I'm going to go to Narva and hopefully I might be able to catch the a performance there. No, it's too late for that, unfortunately. Okay, change of plan. Let's have a quick row around. See what we can find. Doesn't look like there's anything interesting over there. Seeing as we've pretty much got the night to ourselves. Why not do a little bit of fishing? And the fishing pole. We still have some bait, fortunately. Hopefully I don't snap too many lines this time around. That's enough of that, I think. Yeah, I've got to go find some trout. Are those trout? That looks like more of a minnows. Okay. Slowly starting to memorize the names of these fish. Those are definitely the minnows. Those are sandfish and minnows. It's not very helpful. Sandfish. Ooh, boy, that's a big one. Okay. Well, I think I've found old Pops. I just need to find some trout. It looks like I need to go to my old trout fishing spot at the bottom of the waterfall over there. I don't feel like taking the reed boat over that. That seems a little reckless, even for me. Notice there's some floating rocks. There we go. Pack you up for now. And get the bicycle out. And off we go. There they are, and I almost managed to get myself stuck. I am indeed. Larry Large Trout is just about to be caught, in fact. Hello there, Hogan. How are you doing? Okay, maybe you don't want minnows. Why aren't you biting? Did I set the wrong bait? I'm doing quite well, thank you very much. Except, for whatever reason, these fish ain't biting. Strange. There's a definitely. There we go. Gotcha. Does this one look like Larry to you? Is this Larry Large Trout? There we go. Is this the Larry you're looking for? Excellent. I can now call myself a champion fisherman. Well, gonna catch a few of his friends as well. They do have a rather goofy yet terrified expression, don't they? Wow, they're really eager now. I guess they're all trying to join Larry. Which may not turn out so well for them. There we go. That should be 5 trout, assuming I don't break the line on this one. That'll give me 5 shots at Old Pops. The legendary fish of the lake. Ooh. Oh, there's another one. Excellent. Assuming I don't break the line. There we go. Right. Now for the true legend, Old Pops, the monster of the lake. Now we're hoping to get this lady's wedding ring from Old Pops. Apparently Old Pops ate it. And there we go, there's the reed boat. And out we go. We were able to spot a really big fish out this way. Hopefully it hasn't meandered off somewhere. We'll just pretend we didn't notice the bridge just suddenly phase in, huh? There it is. Old Pops. A biggie fishy. Get away. It's okay. Didn't take the bait. I'm getting too eager for this. There, got him. Gotcha. Yeah, I'm not going to let you break this line. I'm not going to let you get away either. Yeah, almost gotcha. Almost gotcha. There we go. Caught Old Pops. He coughed up a ring. I've got the ring now, but should I keep Old Pops or toss him back? Well, I mean, probably worth quite a few glowstones, but I'll keep him in the ecosystem. I tossed Old Pops back into the water and he swam away. We got what we came for, though. The wedding ring. I guess we can pick up a few other fish in the meantime. while we're out here. There we go, gotcha. I will have to go back to Narva at some point, so I can sell the fish then. And these fish are really eager. Better not break the line. That was a feisty one. Yeah, I didn't fall for it that time. That nibble. Looks like it's morning now. A whole night of fishing, pretty much. There, gotcha. Ooh. Getting a little over-eager there. Lay off a little. There we go. That's all the fish I can get for now. I mean, I could always go fishing again later, but there's no real need to at this point. Got a good amount of the items you can get from Narva. And I pretty much have access to the whole... the whole island now, thanks to that weed boat. Hello.
You found me, my ring traveller, but you didn't bring the old fish.
Yes, unfortunately, he I released him.
I don't need him, per se. I'm so glad just to be reunited with my wedding ring. Thank you for bringing it back.
You're welcome.
Here, have a few glowstones.
I'm sure I would have had a few more.
Thank the great shade you survived.
Few more glowstones if I handed her old pots. Hey, you thought old pots would kill me?
Well, it's hard to be sure. What a mean-spirited old fish. You ever hear the tale of how old Pops came to be so grumpy? No? You're in for a treat.
Well, we got the time.
Well, you see, there was one day old Pops swallowed a bitter frog. So he swallowed this frog, and the taste was so awful, old Pops started thrashing around something terrible. There was a boat nearby. And when old Pops leapt out of the water, he hit it hard. That boat was knocked over, and the captain was real upset. He was yelling and ended up harpooning the giant fish right in the side. Didn't you notice the large gash on old Pops?
Not particularly, no.
So anyhow, old Pops has been bitter ever since. Can't believe you survived fetching my ring from him. That old Pops, he's got it out for us all.
Well, okay. If you say so. Well, with that done, I think it's time to have a stroll through this forest. Make our way back in the vague direction of Narva, but we won't be going to Narva just yet.